It's okay. This heat is like taking over my brain. I'm not able to talk. Hello my gems, this is Shelly, and in today's video I'm going to share some of the very gentle chemical exfoliators for the beginners and also for the people who have very sensitive skin. So before you go out and get yourself a chemical exfoliator, you first need to understand how to identify them and pick the right one as per your skin concern, because there are like AHAs, there are like BHAs, and both have very different function for your skin and they work very differently, so don't mix them up. To make things easy and fast for you, what I'm gonna do is I will be including timestamps for various topics, and you can find them by scrolling at this timeline at the bottom of the video. Like, I've included these chapters. As you scroll through, you will find various topic of today's video, and whatever you are interested in, you can directly click on that and start the video from that part. If you have skin concerns like whiteheads, dullness on skin, rough skin, pigmentation, and you need a product that will help in like overall brightening of your skin tone, then AHAs are the perfect option for you. Like, AHA stands for alpha hydroxy acid, and there are various types of alpha hydroxy acid. So whenever you check the ingredient list of product, if you find any of these ingredients like glycolic acid, lactic acid, mandelic acid, malic acid, tartaric acid, and citric acid, like, these ingredients are nothing but the various types of AHAs, and they all exfoliate and they all work on the surface of your skin to get rid of that dead skin cells and that dullness on your skin, but they vary in strength. And I'm sharing a quick chart in front of you, and through this you can see that glycolic acid is the most potent form of AHA, and as you go down from lactic acid to mandelic acid to the bottom of citric acid, the strength of these AHAs reduces. So if you are a beginner, or if you have like very sensitive skin, I would suggest that you don't start with the glycolic acid. Maybe like you can start with lactic acid or mandelic acid. They are like altogether very safe on skin. Since today's video is made for the people who have very 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 sensitive skin, so I will not be talking about a lot of exfoliating toners. Like, that I've already done in one of my old video, and in today's video I just want to focus on very very gentle chemical exfoliator. The AHA product that I want to introduce to the people who have very sensitive skin, it is the Claire's Daily Skin Softening Water. This is basically a very gentle exfoliating toner, and if you have like normal skin, like a normal skin, note down, like a normal skin, and your skin is like used to all the potent acid, this can be used on a daily basis. But if you are like a beginner, or if you have like very very sensitive skin, then you can start with maybe 2 times per week frequency. So this contains mainly citric acid to exfoliate your skin very gently, and while ago I shared that citric acid is the most gentle form of AHA, and so this is why I'm recommending this to the beginners and also for the people who have sensitive skin. So this Claire's Daily Softening Water is like a toner, and it is to be used on a cotton puff, but for sensitive skin I would suggest that you use it on your palm. Like, you take some on your palm and pat it all over face. So if you feel that even the most gentle form of AHA is not working for you, you need something even more gentle, then try out the minimalist PHA 3% biotic toner. So this contains PHA as its exfoliating ingredient, and PHA stands for polyhydroxy acid, and PHAs are like entirely different thing from AHA. They don't fall into its category, but they work in a similar fashion of AHA. Like, PHA works on your skin surface to get rid of that dead skin cell. It helps in reducing the dullness on your skin, but this might not be that effective on very stubborn acne marks. You are a beginner, or you have very sensitive skin, start with maybe 2-3 times per week frequency, and when you see that your skin is getting used to the product, you can increase the frequency. And if you are like, no, I cannot use PHA, even PHAs are very irritating on my skin, I need something even more gentle, then the product that I want to recommend is the Bivistrin Green Tea and Enzyme Powder Wash. Now, this contains papain. Papain is the enzyme which is obtained from papaya, and it works in a similar fashion like that of AHA, but they are entirely different thing. Basically, this is a powder face wash. Like, you take this powder on your hand and foam it up and then use it on your face just like any other face wash. And also, again, I want to say that since you are a beginner, you have sensitive skin, use it only maybe like 2-3 times per week. And if you are dealing with skin concern like blackheads and excessive sebum, and also you are experiencing breakouts, like breakouts other than whiteheads, the other types of breakout, then you definitely need to check out the BHA. BHA stands for beta hydroxy acid, and just like AHA, even BHA comes in various forms. So if you come across ingredients like salicylic acid, betaine salicylate, willow bark extract, lipohydroxy acid, these are nothing but various types of BHA. BHA works very differently from AHA. Like, AHA works on your skin surface, they get rid of the dead skin cell from the skin surface, but BHA works within your pore. Like, they enter your pores, clean out the dead skin cell which is trapped in your pores, and also reduce the excessive oil in your pores. So basically, BHA works within your skin and AHA works on the surface of your skin. So this is the primary difference. And suddenly I remembered that some of you get confused like whether they should be using AHA or BHA when they are breaking out. So this is one thing you clearly need to understand. Like, AHA prevents the whiteheads, AHA treats the whiteheads, AHA prevents the future breakouts. But when you are breaking out, like there is acne already on your skin surface, at that time you need to use BHA. You first get a whitehead, you get some sort of congestion, and when that gets inflamed, it turns into acne. So this AHA basically gets rid of the dead skin cell, you know, which will be like trapping all that excessive sebum and basically clogging your pore. So AHA helps in getting rid of that. Whereas when you have already inflamed acne, the BHA, what it does, it goes into your pore, reduces that excessive trapped oil, dead skin cell inside your skin, and helps in shrinking down that acne. And this is how things basically work. Like, this is not the exact technicality, but basically things work in this way only, and this is how I proceed with my skincare products. So if you have understood this part, please give this video a big thumbs up. So coming back to the BHA based product, BHAs are mainly helpful to the people who have combination and oily skin, because BHA mainly works by reducing the excessive oil in your skin. But if people with sensitive skin or dry skin, if they use a very potent BHA based product, they sometimes end up with dehydrated or completely dried out skin. And you really don't have to damage and dry out your skin to get good result. You can always opt for products which are like gentle and have lower strength of BHA. So the three products that I will be mentioning are very, very gentle form of BHA. And if you have like sensitive skin, or if you have like very, very dry skin, or if you are a beginner, you can check out this BHA product. The first product that I want to share here is the Benten Aloe BHA Skin Toner. And this contains 0.5% of salicylic acid. And yes, I know that 0.5% of salicylic acid or of lower strength, it is many times used as preservative. But if you have sensitive skin or very dry skin, it's like good enough to be used as a BHA based product. Like, if you fall into the category of oily or combination skin, this toner can safely be used as your regular daily toner. But if you have sensitive or dry skin, use it only 2 times per week as your BHA product. Like, I was testing out this product last month, and I started with 2 times per week frequency, but as I tried to use it more and more, like I tried using this on a daily basis, it dried out my skin. Even though it has a very hydrating and moderately viscous texture, but this still dried out my skin. So that's a clear sign that 0.5% salicylic acid does work on your skin, and if you have sensitive and dry skin and if you try to push it too much, it can dry out your skin. And if you are like, no, salicylic acid is very drying on your skin, you have tried out product that contains 0.5% salicylic acid and you need something very 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 gentle, then you all can check out the Cosrx One Step Pimple Pads, I think this is the name. So these are nothing but a pre-soaked cotton pad, and these cotton pads have been soaked up in a solution that contains willow bark extract and betaine salicylate. So willow bark extract and betaine salicylate, these two ingredients work exactly like almost like salicylic acid, but they are very gentle. So you can try out this product, but again, since you have like dry or sensitive skin, use it only one or two times per week and that should be sufficient. If you are like, no, BHA, like salicylic acid, betaine salicylate and willow bark extract are a bit irritating on my skin, I cannot use it. Like for instance, willow bark extract is a bit irritating on my skin, I cannot use this ingredient, so I avoid it in my skincare product. So if you fall into this sort of category of people, then the next product is definitely for you, and it is the Rovectin LHA Blemish Ampoule. Now this uses LHA as the exfoliating ingredient, and while ago I mentioned that lipohydroxy acid works exactly like your BHA. They are the new generation BHA and they work in a very similar fashion like your salicylic acid, but they are very 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 gentle. For instance, people with oily combination skin can safely use this product on a daily basis, but if you have like sensitive skin or very dry skin, use it maybe 2-3 times per week at night and that should be sufficient. Or you can also use it by adding 2-3 drops of this product to a moisturizer and then use it on your face. And before I end this video, I quickly want to share this video over here. Like in this video, I have already talked about so many chemical exfoliator that I have used till date. I have talked about things like which skin type should be using it in what frequency. So all the details are included over here. Definitely check it out. And the second video over here, like here I have shared some do's and don'ts and all the frequently asked question on chemical exfoliator. So these two are the video I insist that you check out, and I will see you in my next upload. Bye.